lean over like this. You can see everybody. I look like ants.
Hey, I don't want to be like a pain or anything, but I think we should start on our project. I mean, this is cool and all, but it's sort of like due in like a few days. I just want to do it now.
Yeah, we should probably get started on that.
All right.
Yeah.
Jens would accuse day off to bring you the main points of our presentation.
We're sure you're enjoying the program, but how about we tell you a little more about the Art Institute, eh?
The Art Institute was established May 24th, 1879 as the Chicago Academy of Fine Arts. The name change was made on December 23rd, 1882. The establishment was brought to its current location on Michigan Avenue in 1893 and was designed by Shepley, Rutan, and Coolidge, a well-known architecture firm back then.
Can you say some stuff?
Sorry.
The original building was designed in the French Renaissance style, a common one back then, and was created for the World's Columbian Exposition. The Institute took possession of the building November 1st, 1893, and remained unchanged for quite some time. Renovations did not begin until the late 20th century and commenced with the adding of 216,500 square feet to the building itself.
Wow, fascinating. And now back to the program already in progress.
St. Ferris.
It was established in 1879, but it wasn't called that at that time. It was, the name was changed to the Art Institute in 1882. And then what else do you want to know about?
Well, how long have you been working here so far?
I don't really work here. I'm a volunteer. And there are lots of volunteers who actually give our time to the Art Institute. And I've done it for 7 years. Ever since I retired, yes.
So, do you get a lot of cultures, different cultures, people
who come? Lots of people. Lots of Europeans who are looking for French Impressionists, lots of Asians, lots of South Americans, speaking different languages.
Do you learn any cultures or anything in your time here? Have you learned?
Well, people come and they ask about particular painters, so I can look it up in my computer here, and I've learned a lot of different painters' names I didn't know before.
So how do you become a volunteer here?
You make out an application, you tell them why you want to volunteer, and
accept it.
You are.
Okay. Thank you very much. Have a good one.
Thanks so much. This just in, that presentation was awesome.
What he means to say is that there's a little more info we'd like you to know.
Ah, right.
That. From 1985 until 2002, several changes were made to the Art Institute. New collections of art were added and others were renovated. Everything from Africa and the ancient Americas to the modern art galleries were touched up. The Fullerton Hall was restored, and the main entrance was modernized for today's art viewers.
There are 10 museum collections in the Art Museum and over 270 galleries. The departments include African and Amerindian art, American arts, architecture and design, Asian and ancient art, European decorative art, medieval to modern European painting and sculpture, photography, prints and drawings, and textile art.
Holy cow!
I know, right?
Over 600 volunteers work at the Art Institute. No one actually works there except for the guards and janitors. If you want to check out the Art Institute, it's $12 for adults and children over the age of 12. But hey, we're students, so we only have to pay $7.
And if you can pretend to be 12 or under, you can get in for free. Just bend your knees. It's easy.
Thanks for watching, and see you next time here on the Ferris Bueller Network.
Day.
Yeah, taxi.
Wish that I could fly away.
Amen.
Tell her, do something.
Party, man.
Counting teardrops in my
It must be.